Hello, today I'm going to talk about the design rules for test point. So this is a simple series voltage regulator. You can see that I put some test point in this schematic. So these are my test points, TP1, TP2, TP3, TP4, TP5 and TP6, which I transfer from my schematic to the PCB. Here you can see that those test points. Till now I didn't define any kind of design rules for these test points. So that's why when I'm performing the design rule check, then I'm not getting any kind of error. How you can define the design rule for the test point? There are basically four design rules for the test point which you have to define and which are also important for the PCB layout. The first one is the clearance constraint between the test point and the THT connector. If you have a THT connector, for example, in my case, I'm having here this THT connector. So between this THT connector and the test point on top as well as on the bottom. Second, clearance constraint between the test point and the SMD connector on top and bottom. Then the third one is design rule between the two test points, that there should be at least 2.54 millimeter distance between the two test points so that your PCB manufacturer can do the ICT test. And the fourth one is for the rest of the component on your PCB. So design rule between clearance design rule for the clearance constraint between test point and the rest of the component. So to define the design rule for the test point, first you have to define the test point class. So to define the test point classes, what you have to do, you have to go to the design, and in the design you have to open the classes, and then in classes you have this component classes. By right clicking on the component classes, and then you can add the new class, and let's call this class, I already defined here, let's call this class test point. And in the once you will define the test point, then it will show you all the non-members of this class, and from the non-member of this class you have to select the test point and bring it to the member of this component class. So which you can see here, in my case I already put the test point in the member class of component class of test point. So you can also define here. Then the important thing is that you have to also define the, in case if you have a THT connector or a SMD connector, so you have to also define the class for all those connectors. Here in my case I am only having a THT connector, so that's why here you can see that I already defined the component class for the THT connector, and X1 and X2 are the member of this THT component class. So here if you have a SMD connector, then you can just right click here and add a class and define the as a component class for SMD connector and bring that component in the member class of SMD connector. So in my case I don't have, so I'm not going to define. So let me show you how you can define the design rule for the test point. So to define the design rule, what you have to do, you have to go to the design and then choose design rules, and in the design rules you have to go to the here in the component clearance and right click here and add a new rule. So let's call this rule component clearance between test point and the THT connector, and let's call this on the top side of your PCB. So here what you have to do, where the first object matches, you have to select here the custom query, and where the second object matches, here also you have to select the custom query. And in custom query you have to write in, sorry, in the first custom query you have to write in component class. As soon as you write in component class, it will show you the component class which you have defined. So here in our case it's test point. And my suggestion is that it's always better to have the test point only on one side of the PCB, either on the top side or bottom side. But I will here define the test point, design rule on the both side. So in component class TP and on top. And then you have to here define the in component class, and this is TST and on top. In the constraint for the vertical clearance mode, I think we don't need, so you can choose here in infinite. And minimum horizontal clearance, here you have to take for the horizontal clearance between the test point and your TST connector or SMD connector, 2 mm, because for example, if you have a TST connector, then you have to keep some space for the machine to press this connector into your PCB, and so that's why this 2 mm, we need a clearance constraint of at least 2 mm. And then after that, here you have to select show actual violation distances, so which means that when the violation will occur, then at that time it will show you how close is your test point near to the TST connector. So if it's not 2 mm, then it will show you exact distance, so you can shift your test point at least 2 mm away from the TST connector. Then let's add the second rule. Let's call this component clearance constraint between test point, TST connector on bottom. So again, where the first object matches, here you have to select the custom query, and where the second object matches, also you have to define here the custom query. And again, here in the custom query, you have to write in component class. As soon as you write the component class, it will show you all the classes of the component which you already defined in the classes. And here you have to write it's on the bottom side, on bottom. And then here you have to define the in component class TST connector and on bottom. Then here in the constraint vertical clearance mode infinite, again you have to define here the distance 2 mm, and you have to select this show actual violation distances. Okay, so we have we already defined the design rule for the TST connector. Same, you can define the design rule for SMD connector. Instead of TST, you have to just define the in classes, you have to define first the SMD connector as a component class, and here instead of TST, you have to choose the SMD. Then the next one is the new rule is component clearance between test point to test point. You have to just select here component class, and you can choose here test point. And where the second object matches, here also you have to define the component class, and you have to choose here test point. And then for this vertical clearance, you can define 0.01 millimeter. And the distance between the two test point, if you have seen my previous video, then I have told you that it should be 2.54 millimeter center to center between the two test point, which is sufficient to perform the ICT test. So if you will calculate from the edge of the test point to the between the two edges of the test point, so it comes around 1.34 millimeter. So that is the horizontal distance, 1.34 millimeter. That is the minimum horizontal clearance between the two test point. And then you have to choose this show actual violation distances. The last design rule is component clearance between the test point and all the components which are present on the top side. So all on top. So here also you have to define the custom query where the first object matches, and for the second object matches also you have to define the custom query. Here in the first object matches in component class test point, and on top here you have to just define the on top layer, on top I mean. So vertical clearance, in my case it's not important, so I'm not going to define the vertical clearance. If in your case if it's important, then you can just specify how much vertical clearance you need. Then horizontal clearance for the rest of the component is I think 0.5 millimeter is sufficient, and then again you have to choose this show actual violation distances. You should also define the design rule for the test point on the bottom side. I only define here, for example, for all the component on the top side. And in case if you are using the SMD connector and TSG both, then you have to also define the design rule for the SMD connector. Or let me define here also from the also for the bottom side. I mean for the all component on the bottom side. So here add a new rule and clearance constraint between test point all and then to bottom. Then here you have to again choose the custom query in component class test point and on bottom, and here custom query on bottom. So whatever the components are available on the bottom side, this rule applies to them. Then select here for vertical, in my case I don't need, so infinite, and horizontal clearance is 0.5 millimeter, and then select this show actual violation distances, and here you can go and set the priorities for this rule. Otherwise the rule won't be applied in a proper way. So what you have to do here, you have to set the first give the first priority to the test component clearance between the test point and the TSG connector on top. So increase its priority, bring it to the top, and then the second one is test point between test point and TSG connector on the bottom. Then if you have SMD connector, then that should be the next. Here in my case I don't have, so I didn't define that. Then the third one is between the test point to test point, and then the fourth one is between the test point and the all the other components. That's how you can define. Then say close, apply all these rules. So we have defined the design rule for the test point, and let me show you in 3D mode. I intentionally place this test point near to the TSG connector, as in our design rule we have defined that this distance should be from edge to edge at least 2 millimeter. But here as you can see that it's not 2 millimeter, it's something around 0.5 millimeter. So here I'm expecting that it should give me a design rule error, and here also the distance between the two test point center to center should be 2.5 millimeter. So here I'm also expecting the design rule error, and let me check this distance. So this is also 1.75, which means that we will also get the design error for this test point, and I placed one test point very near to this pad, which we define on the top side, and the bottom side should be at least minimum distance should be 0.5 millimeter in this case. So it's around 0.2 millimeter. So let's do the design rule check. So you have to go to the tool and then select the design rule check. And here make sure that you have selected the here batch. You have enabled the component clearance. Otherwise it will not perform the design rule check for that. So run the design rule check, and here I'm getting 11 rule violations, and all the rule violations are for the test point. Here you can see that this is for the test point, fabrication test point usage, and all the rule violations are for the test point. So here, as I said, that it's also showing you the distance between the two component, which is here between the test point and the TST connector. So here also, and then here, yeah, this is 1.5 millimeter. The distance between these two is 1.5 millimeter, and this is 1.1 millimeter. So let me shift to these two test point away from each other as well as away from the TST connector. This distance should be also at least. So report the polygon, and then again go to tools, design rule check, and run the design rule. So here you have only 6 rules violation, and there is no design rule error for the test point design rule what we have defined. And these 6 design rule violations are, so here 2 of them are, there is a missing test point. So it's showing that this one showing that this fabric missing required test point, because you have defined the test point where your test points are present, either on the top side or on the bottom side for the fabrication. So for that, what you have to do, you have to just click on this test point, and here you have to go to the properties test point, and you have to define that this, you have to click here on the top side, and when again I will perform the design rule, then I am expecting that there is no error for this design rule. So let's do the design rule. So here you can see that the rule violation is reduced from 6 to 5, and yeah, when you will do that for all the component, then for example all the test points, then it won't be anymore there. So let me select all the test point one by one. In your case, you can use the find the similar object, and from there you can apply. Here in my case, I have a less test point, so I can do individually. Yeah, so I'm expect when I will perform the design rule, then I'm expecting that there won't be any kind of design rule error. So here you can see that there are no design rule error for the test points, and yeah, that's how you can define the design rule for the test point. Thank you very much. If you like my content, then please subscribe to my channel. Have a nice day. Bye.